गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो स्टार्ट विद योर चैप्टर दैट इज मैनेजमेंट ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स सर्विसेज इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड प्रोग्राम्स फॉर चिल्ड्रन यूथ एंड एल्डरली. नाउ दिस इज योर सेकेंड पार्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यूथ प्रोग्राम्स इन इंडिया. द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ यूथ अफेयर्स एंड स्पोर्ट्स अडॉप्टेड द नेशनल यूथ पॉलिसी इन 2003. सो द फर्स्ट इज योर द नेशनल सर्विस स्कीम दैट इज NSS aims at involve college level students in programs of social service and national development like construction and repair of roads, school buildings, village ponds, tanks, activities related to environmental and ecological improvement like tree plantation, removal of weeds from lakes, digging pits, activities related to hygiene and sanitation, family welfare, child care, mass immunization, vocational training of craft, tailoring meeting and organizing cooperatives. So second program is your the National Service Volunteer Scheme provide opportunity to students who have completed their first degree to involve themselves on a whole time basis for a short period of 1 or 2 years in programs of national development mainly through Nehru Yuva Kendras. Third program is your promotion of adventure. Many clubs and voluntary organization organize activities like mountaineering, trekking, hiking, exploration of collection of data, study of flora and fauna in the mountains, forests, deserts and sea, canoeing, coastal sailing, raft exhibition, swimming, cycling, etc. by using the financial assistance provided by the government for promotion of adventure. And next one is your scout and guides. The government provide financial support for training scouts and guides, organizing rallies, jamborees, etc. This aims at developing the character of boys and girls to make them good citizens by inculcating in them a spirit of loyalty, patriotism, and thoughtfulness for others. So, next one is your Commonwealth Youth Program. India is participating in the Commonwealth Youth Program, which is aimed at making the youth participate in development processes of their respective countries and to provide a forum for increasing cooperation and understanding among the Commonwealth countries. Under this program, 3 regional centers for advanced studies in youth work have been set up in India, Zambia and Ghana. The Asia Pacific Regional Center has been set up at Chandigarh, India. So next one is your promotion of national integration. Financial assistance is given by the government to many voluntary agencies to organize visits of youth living in one state to another state, which mark cultural differences in order to promote greater understanding of the historical and cultural heritage of the country, of the problems being faced by the people of different regions and environment, social custom, etc. In other parts of the country, camps, seminar, etc. are also organized with the objective of promoting national integration. So next topic is your why are elderly vulnerable. So in a number of countries, a senior citizen is a person in the age group 65 years and above. However, in India, senior citizens constitute person in the age group of 60 years and above. There has been a steady rise in the population of older person in India since life expectancy, which was approximately 29 years in 1947, has increased to 69.3 years in 2009-13 for females and 65.8 years for males. India is home to the second largest number of senior citizens in the world after China. The number of elderly will account for nearly 9% of the population in 2016. The special features of elderly population in India are majority 80% of them are in the rural areas, thus making service delivery a challenge. Feminization of elderly population, increase in number of old person above 80 years, a large percentage 30% of senior citizen is below the poverty line. So the elderly are vulnerable group due to various reasons. Firstly, health is a major concern for many individuals at this age. The elderly are more vulnerable to disease because of decreased physiological reserves and defense mechanism. Besides illness, the aging process itself leads to certain disabilities such as low vision and blindness resulting from the cataracts, deafness resulting from nerve impairment, loss of mobility from arthritis, and the general inability to care for oneself. Secondly, in the family life cycle for many, this may be a period when they find themselves alone because the children are likely to have moved away from the family, either because of marriage or to earn a living. Many may experience feelings of loneliness, isolation, and a sense of being a burden on others. The above description should not make you think that there are only problems and difficulties in old age. Many old people continue to living fulfilling lives. In many families, the elderly are well respected and continue to find fulfillment. Their ability to lead healthy and fruitful lives should be ensured by the government. The government adopted them National Policy for Older Person in 1999. So, some programs for the elderly persons: government, non-government organization, Panchayati Raj institution, local bodies are implementing different type of programs for the elderly in India. Some of the programs operating in the country for the elderly are as follows. Programs catering to the basic needs for older person, particularly food, shelter and health care to the destitute elderly. Programs to build and strengthen intergenerational relationship, particularly between children, youth and older person. Programs for encouraging active and productive aging. Programs for providing institutional as well as non-institutional care service to older person. Research, advocacy and awareness. Building programs in the field of aging. Old age home to provide food, care and shelter. Respite care homes and continuous care homes for older person who live in old age homes but are seriously ill, requiring continuous nursing care and respite. So, multi-service center for older person to provide daycare, educational and entertainment opportunities, healthcare companionship, mobile Medicare unit to provide medical care to the older person living in rural and isolated and backward areas, daycare centers for Alzheimer's disease, dementia patients to provide specialized daycare, helplines and counseling center for older person, mental health care and specialized care for the older person to provide mental health care intervention programs to the elderly, disability and hearing aids for older person, physiotherapy clinics for older person, awareness generation programs for older person and caregivers like self-care, preventive health care, disease management, preparation for old age, healthy and productive aging, intergenerational bonding, training for caregivers to the older person, sensitizing programs for children, particularly in schools and colleges. And last one is your National Old Age Pension Scheme, that is NOAPS, meant for older person who are considered destitute, that is not having any regular means of subsistence on their own or through financial support from family members. Beneficiaries should be of 65 years, need to provide proof of age and their destitute status. The state government can add to the amount from their own resource. So, preparing for the career. In the career choice, you may either work as in charge or manager of certain activities in an already functioning program institution, or you may choose to initiate setup of organization program for the youth, children or the elderly. Whatever be in case, it will be career for which you will be required to develop a broad knowledge base and multiple skills. So, the following are the some skills or abilities you will need to develop. First is your people skill. Running or working in an organization means interacting with people in different roles and from different backgrounds. The following are some groups or people you are likely to interact with. First is the community. A program or an institution for children will be successful if the community feels a sense of involvement and ownership with it. This happens when the program is planned by involving the people for whom it is intended right from the start. Participatory planning, management and implementation are the pillars of effective programs. Thus, building linkage with the community and invoking community participation will be the major aspect of your work. So, second is the private sector. The private sector financial institution companies and organizations have come in a big way to support innovative programs and institutions. This is a positive step as it is an opportunity for the private sector to discharge its social responsibilities. So third one is the official in the government. You may need to interact with government departments for various purposes, including funding and fulfilling other legal requirements. And fourth one is people within the organization. For smooth functioning of the organization, it is important that the people, both beneficiaries and personal working therein, enjoy a harmonious relationship with each other. Cultivating cordial interpersonal relations is a major factor in the success of an organization. So, last one is your administrative skill. Running or managing an organization or program involves handling finances, recruiting personnel, renting space, buying equipment, maintaining records and stocks. While there may be other specific people dealing with each of these aspects, it would also be necessary and helpful for you to have a basic understanding of the issues involved in such of these. So, the need of program and institution for children, youth and elderly which provide quality services will continue to remain a basic need of civil society. The first step in preparation for this career is to develop a knowledge base and an understanding about children, youth and the elderly. Towards this end, it will be appropriate to obtain an undergraduate degree in home science, also known by other names such as family and community science or social work or any other social sciences. The Indira Gandhi National Open University offer programs which may be of interest to you. These programs can be done along with studying for the regular degree course. Some such courses are Certificate Program in NGO Management, Diploma in Youth Development Work. There are state open universities as well which offer programs through the distance mode. It will be worthwhile to explore the websites of IGNU and other state open universities for more details. So, last one is your scope. What's the scope in these schemes? Depending upon the type of program you wish to be involved with and you own inclination, the field offers a variety of possibilities. Career avenues are shown below. So, what's your career avenues? Set up your own institution for service to any target group. Be a manager in an established institution or a program. Be a functionary at level cater. Be a researcher consulting with assessing, evaluating, exciting programs and institution. So, now we have completed your 3 chapters. Three units. This chapter is your last chapter. Okay. Thank you so much.